Right, so you guys are now, about a year ago, we put the iTech 200 lithium battery into our system. And with that, we actually disconnected the original Jayco Setec unit that controls the 12 volt system in the van. And up until now, all of our charging has been done either through solar or through the alternator of the car when we're towing to wherever we're going. And from that video, we've had loads of questions about, can a standard Jayco Setec unit charge a lithium battery? So what we're going to do today is hook the original Setec unit back up, which is still connected to the lithium iTech battery, and just see how they work together, see how they interact, see if the Setec actually does put enough charge into the lithium battery to actually charge it up to 100%. So basically all that we're going to be doing for this install is taking a normal 240 volt socket and installing it onto the original Setec cable, and then plugging it straight back into the factory mounted Jayco 240 volt outlet. And hopefully everything is going to work exactly the same as if that battery is just an AGM. So that's pretty much it. Plug's all wired up. So all we've got to do now is plug it in, run 240 into the camper trailer, and see how the iTech battery reacts with the Setec unit. We're going to be tracking everything through the Adam Power shunt. Video on the Adam Power shunt will be in the description box below. So let's hook this thing up and see how it goes. All right, so let's plug the 240 into the camper trailer and see what the Setec puts into the battery. So 240's on, we're 240 in the van, everything's running at the moment. It's powering up the Setec. I've switched it over to the battery, but the big question is it actually charging the lithium battery? Let's jump down to the battery monitor and see exactly what's going on with it. So as you guys can see, yes, you definitely can charge with your Setec unit, but it comes at a cost of charging very slowly. So you're gonna charge at around, so far I've seen between 2.5 and 4.9, so 2.5 and 5 amps.
Now that would be okay if the Setec unit could get above 13.8 volts and provide a full 14.4 volts, which we all know lithiums need to get through that absorption level of charge.
I've not been able to get any more than 5 amps out of the Setec, and I think that is by design. I've had a look at the manual. I'll leave a link down in the description box below if you want to check out the manual. The manual basically says that the Setec unit is a 12 volt converter with the ability to trickle charge a battery. So yes, the Setec will charge your battery if you give it long enough. For us, it's definitely not the most effective way to charge a battery. But if we get back from a trip or we're going to a caravan park or something like that, yes, it's definitely a good option. You can plug it in, it'll just trickle charge away at a constant nice 5 amps and still run everything in your camper trailer or your caravan, whatever you've got. So the answer is yes, you will charge your lithium battery through the Setec unit, but it's gonna be really, really small. You're only gonna be putting in 3 to 5 amps. 5 amps I've seen at the bulk level, and that's about it. So you're gonna be getting a slow trickle charge, but I mean, if that's what you're into, if that's what you need, then yep, the Setec is gonna keep you covered. If you're looking for a big bulk charge, you might wanna bump it up to a bigger 240 volt charger. But thank you guys for all your comments and questions on the last video. That has been the reason for this. And also, if you've got any comments or questions about how this has been going since I've done it, leave me in the comment section down below and I'll be sure to get back to you guys as soon as I can. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel to keep up to date with all the mods that we're doing to this camper and also the ute. And I'll see you guys in the next one.